What's good, everybody? This is Robo from All Bark, back with another video. Today on the channel, I'm going to be going over the final two games of the Salt Lake City Summer League. I'm going to continue doing this for the Vegas Summer League as well, so stay tuned for daily videos over the next 10 days or so. Starting off with the first of the two games, the Oklahoma City Thunder took down the Philadelphia 76ers 100-91. The score doesn't show the nature of this game well, as it was an absolute beatdown for three quarters. And then the 76ers came alive and went on a huge run in the fourth to tighten the game up and make it pretty interesting, as they cut it down to a 5-point game with 2 minutes to play, but they just couldn't get any closer than that. The Thunder sat Chet Holmgren for this one as expected, and Cason Wallace was still unable to play due to some weird league trade policies, but he'll 100% be good to go for the first game in Vegas, and I expect to see Chet out there playing then as well. Trey Mann continued his dominant summer league showing for the Thunder with 23 points, 8 boards, and 5 assists, and yet another efficient shooting performance. He's taken huge steps so far this summer and looks ready for better production off the Thunder bench this season. Usman Dieng took advantage of the opportunity with a lot of guys out and had by far his best scoring performance of the summer league, going 10 for 12 from the field for 22 points. He also grabbed 10 boards and 3 steals as well. The rough part of the night for him came with 9 turnovers. He really just forced a lot as a main ball handler, but again, it's just summer league, that's not something the Thunder are really too concerned with. Jared Butler had a nice game with 9 points, 5 assists, and 3 steals as a starting guard. Former first-round pick Zaire Smith made an appearance in this one, going perfect from the field on 6 attempts. He had 16 points on the bench for OKC. Lastly, undrafted defensive ace Caleb McConnell out of Rutgers stuffed the stat sheet in this one. He only played 14 minutes of action, but he had 8 points, 4 assists, 3 steals, and a block. For the 76ers, Jaden Springer was the best on the floor for Philly yet again. He finished with 17 points, 5 boards, 2 assists, and both a steal and a block. Terquavion Smith had a solid bounce-back game, shooting 5 for 11 in this one for 15 points. Javante Smart continued his solid summer league performance with 11 points, 4 assists, and 2 steals. It wasn't the best game from Ricky Council off the bench, but he had a good summer league showing so far, and I think he could definitely still be in play for a two-way contract with the Sixers after the summer league continues. Lastly, former Trailblazer Greg Brown played just 15 minutes in this game, but he had 11 points and a pair of blocks, as well as a couple of steals, and was really active defensively overall. Both teams have the day off tomorrow, obviously, as they travel to Vegas to compete again on Saturday.
Little drive by the Sixers. Nice floater. Maybe the easiest bucket of the night for the Sixers from the corner. Smart quickly in the front court. He'll turn, fire up a three. In and out. And the push. The roll up on a minute left. Catch and shoot from the corner.
Blow the game open.
Absolutely. Nice drive. Look by Shackelford. Philly rolls in,
which is really good news. He's been nursing a hamstring injury.
Where it had to be.
Gotta take advantage, and that's a play that you have to use.
Let's try to watch this one down the drain, Thurl, but still, that was a 30-second point that opened on the wing. Philly looking for a shot. Springer lowers the shoulder. Contact made and counted.
I like this move here, is bring Terquavion Smith back, let him play off the ball.
A and a half ago, he was just kind of leaning back in the chair, but now he's leaning forward, and he's much more attentive of what's happening.
Ooh, on Philly's side, but that's where you want the basketball.
Smart blows you to sleep on that drive. Wow, just barely got the ball to Jank. He forces it out. The three's up. What a big bucket, as Mann still holds that right hand. Pumps a deep three. Bang.
The second game of the day came between the Grizzlies and Jazz, where Utah came away with an easy victory in this one, 98-83. The Jazz were led by another great game from Oche Agbaji, who finished with 22 points, 13 boards, and 4 assists. He shot 40% from the field as well. Rookie Keontae George did not see his shot fall much, but he was still able to put up 15, 6, and 5. He was very effective at getting to the line in this one, as he took 10 free throws, and getting his teammates involved throughout the game was a big force of emphasis for him. Micah Potter had 10 points and 6 rebounds in 19 minutes. And backup big man Vernon Carey played pretty well off the bench, collecting 9 points and 7 boards as well. And he also had a pair of steals. Johnny Juzang was hot off the bench, going 6 for 9 with a few 3-pointers made, finishing with 15 points overall for the game. On the losing side of this game, the Grizzlies sat Kenny Lofton, David Roddy, Vince Williams, and Jake LaRavia, all who were starters for the previous two games. So some other guys got bigger opportunities in this matchup. The player of the game for the Grizzlies was easily G.G. Jackson, putting together his best performance in the summer league. He had 23 points, 10 rebounds, and only 2 turnovers in 28 minutes. He shot fairly well from the floor, around 40%, and went 4 for 9 from deep, and he's looked really solid offensively so far this summer league, which is somewhat surprising when you consider his age being only 18 and his lack of experience level to this point. Late second round draft pick Tarek Biberovich played quite a bit for the Grizzlies, and despite a poor shooting night, he knocked down a few threes and finished with 13 points and 6 boards. Former Lakers G Leaguer Joel Ayayi out of Gonzaga showed out on the bench, going 4-for-5 from the field. He had 10 points and 4 assists. Outside of that, it was basically a collective effort in the loss for Memphis, as again, they sat out the majority of the rotation to rest for Vegas in a couple days.
Former South Carolina star, Vernon Carey Jr. So it's going to be interesting to see how Memphis comes and starts the season as Ujang drops
offensively.
Here's Jackson again. Drops loose. Chamanich. Oh.
But he was efficient. 5 points, 4 rebounds, and some really good defense.
Kinsey blocked the shot from behind the breakaway. Luka. Across midcourt. He'll pass out. Zverevich. And a 10-point ball game. Ochai's wide open. There you go.
About Luka and Chamanich. He was in San Antonio where Will Hardy was an assistant coach.
Oh, big time.
Seeing him as more of a primary player now. We saw him last year. That's a primary shot.
There's going to come a point where, these guys are still going to shoot it, but teams are going to figure out some different 6 out of 10 times in post-ups, then maybe they go that way. But I don't know if kids are different right here. Justice, I like the way he's playing. He's just solid. And, Vernon Carey.
George against Ferrari. Nice screen by Potter.
Oh, Mouse. Get
rolls
him.
Down
get
low.
Him.
He's got it. Yep.
A mismatch inside again if the Jazz can find it. Ochai in full circle, and he was rewarded for moving without the basketball. Nice job. Oh, good position and helping feel comfortable.
Ochai got it back.
About Keontae is he is learning in real time, and you see him get better and better every time.
Thrilled at Potapinko, the summer league head coach from Memphis, wants this young man. Save Ferrari, picked up by the Jazz. Juzang. Lob it up, put it home. Oh, Ochai. Oh.
It was a small 2-game slate to wrap up the Salt Lake City Summer League action Thursday, but as I mentioned, Friday is a loaded 8-game slate in Las Vegas that includes Wemby's debut and Brandon Miller facing off against him, so I'm looking forward to that for sure. I'll have another recap video of all those games up the following afternoon on Saturday, so stay on the lookout for that video. Other than that, that's going to be it for this video, guys. Thanks again for watching, and I'll see you guys in the next video. Peace.